Hello everyone. I'm going to make a tutorial here showing how to make some screenshots of your room to turn in and talk about cameras a little bit. So here's the room, and you can think about making your screenshots. It might help for you to turn on your resolution gate, which is right here. So look, there's this little panel here. It has some names on it: view, shading, lighting, show, render, panels. And look for this little emblem here. It has a square around a blue dot. I have tooltips on, so it shows me what it is, resolution gate. And you can see there what's how your camera is going to frame the scene. I have up here my resolution is 1280 by 720. You can change that by going to your render settings. You can find that here in this little looks like a clapper with a a little utilities thing. You can also go to Windows, rendering editors, and render settings. Then you can change your image format. I would change it to JPEG. You can give it a name here. I'll just call it test room. That won't work. Well, anyways, you'll see. Later on, we'll change this to do multiple frames, but for now, we'll just do single. You can scroll down, and here you can also change if you have a different camera. If you've made a camera, you can choose that camera, and here you can change your render size. I'm going to ask you all to do 720 by 1280. That's a good medium size. So there you are. Let's say we like that. So then you can always, change it a little bit. Remember, you can always press Q for going back to your general tool if you don't like what you the tool that you have. Okay, so let's just test that out. I'm going to go right here to this is the render current frame. You can also go up to Arnold since we're using Arnold and go to render. Finally, you can also turn on your you can turn on your Arnold tab here and use that button. So there you go. I'm going to zoom out a little bit to just see the whole image. If you like it, I mean, it's pretty plain, but that's fine. We can then wait for it to finish rendering here. And once it does, then you just wait for it to finish rendering so it doesn't get all any of the artifacts. Go to File, you can save your image, and you can do your drop down here so you know where it's going. I'm gonna put mine on my desktop just for now, and see here you can actually give it a different name. I'll call mine Room One, and it's gonna go on my desktop. I'll just press Save, and then if I look at my desktop, I know you can't see mine there, but I'm just opening it. And there it is, room one. Okay, so that's okay. Not the most exciting, but that's fine. Hopefully you'll have some more stuff in your room than I do. We could do like kind of a, don't know, we could do something where we're zooming in. Again, you can do all sorts of, you can render this from different places. I'm just gonna render it from there. Okay, so you like that, wait for it to finish rendering. And then you'll save it the same way we did. I'll show you in a second how to do some different things with your cameras. We talked in class how you can change the focal length, and or the you can change the type of lens you're using. We're using a 35 milliliter lens right here, and which is just kind of a standard that was created a long time ago to sort of mimic how we see. But we can change that. So let's go to File, Save Image to save this. That's fine. I'm gonna again put mine desktop room two. You can name yours however. You could also put your name behind it. I'm just gonna use my first initial last name. You can save it. You can see here on my desktop that there's room one. Save. And then if I look at my desktop, there it is. Okay, so should be pretty easy. Just remember a few things. This is how you see your resolution gate. You may or may not want that on. So you can see the resolution gate right there. There's different settings for it depending on what you like in terms of this. So you could just see how you want the square to come up. Again, you can look at your render settings and change some things there. You could be more advanced if you wish and pump that up. Just know it'll take longer. All right, so if you want to change some things about your camera, we're going to look at the camera settings. Okay, so if you don't have your outliner open, you can click it here to turn on your outliner. Look for your camera here. So my camera here is called Perspective. It's just a little grayed out, but that's fine. That's the perspective camera I'm using. I can also see right there, it's the perspective window at the bottom of my window here. And we look over here and we see we have perspective shape. That's great. So Our angle of view is 54.4. Our focal length, the kind of lens we're using, is 35. Now look, I just want you to pay attention. I'm not changing the position of the camera at all. This is the position of the camera, okay? We can always just zero it. Well, I'll just leave it for now. Just, you know, I know that's a complicated number, but here, let's just make it a little more simple. We can just type in some numbers there. All right. So you see, I'm not going to change the, maybe I'll put, make these a little simpler, negative 128. Okay. So there we go. I'm not going to change the position of the camera. I'm just going to change the type of lens. I'm going to change the focal length. I'm going to make it more of a wide angle. I type in 25. You see, I get more information in my scene. But if we go back to the channel box, I have not changed the position of the camera at all. Okay, I've just changed the type of lens. Conversely, you know, or actually we can even increase that more to go to more of a fisheye. I'll just choose 11, and you see it starts to distort the image. That's fine if that's the technique you want. Going back to 35, again, I haven't changed the, just go back to 11, and you can see I haven't changed the position of the camera, just the type of lens. 35, let's try 50. 50 is a lens that people use for portraits often. Okay, you see I get less information, but I'm closer up. 50 also, you can play around with your depth of field with a more, a longer lens, which means a more telephoto lens. It's good for playing around with your depth of field. If you want to, we could even do more of a telephoto lens, like 120, and it really gets in there close. Okay, again, I haven't changed the position of the camera. All right, I'm just gonna go back to 35. And yeah, just play around with that. And also, I just want to make note of what we talked about in terms of vector versus raster. And, you know, again, this, you know, I don't know exactly the technical terms, but what I mean by vector here in this program is that we can scale in, we can keep zooming in on our objects here, and the resolution will stay the same. I know there's not a lot of complexity here. But no, it won't stay the same. Sorry, it'll keep changing. It'll keep updating. So Illustrator is a little bit like that as well. You can keep zooming in and you'll keep getting more information. The same is not true when you render it. When you render it, you've rasterized this image. Okay, so we can zoom in and we start to see pixels in our images. The same is not true when you're in a vector system. Because you get the computer is continuously updating that information as you zoom in or zoom out. All right. So yeah, just do 4 to 5 images. Of course, I'd love for you to add some more information here to your scene, add some more objects before you do. But that's it for now. Thank you.